Hi, welcome to the IB chemistry class. Everybody knows that IB is the international baccalaureate course for consisting of two types, that is the standard level and the higher level. In IB chemistry, that is international baccalaureate chemistry, there are 11 chemistry topics. Today is the first class of acids and bases. One of the topic, 8th topic of IB chemistry is acids and bases. And for that, we are just discussing the multiple choice questions and the method of arriving such multiple choice questions within short time, in a logical way and easier way. First, see the question. The K value for an acid is 1 times 10 raised to minus 2. And what is the Kb value for its conjugate base? We have given four options, A, B, C, D. You can read that it is 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the power minus 6, 10 to the power minus 10, and 10 to the power minus 12. Those students who know that Ka is the acid ionization constant and Kb is the base ionization constant, and the relationship between Kb and Ka, or Ka and Kb, and what is that is equal to, or Ka Kb is equal to what, if they know, within seconds they can answer the question. Today I am addressing the normal students who want to tackle such problems easily. For that, I will explain the entire thing within short time. You know, to save time, I am writing this here. As we have already said, K is the acid ionization constant, or it is the equilibrium constant. All weak acids and weak bases will be having an equilibrium, that means forward and backward reactions taking place. A weak acid like HA will ionize in water and will form the hydronium ion and A negative. We know that HA is the acid, and therefore A minus, that is deprived of a proton, is called a conjugate base. And automatically the water will act as a base here and will form a conjugate acid, that is hydronium ion. So vast majority of acids are weak acids, and one among them is represented here. Or simply we can write that HA is undergoing an ionization proton donor. Acids are proton donor, H positive and A negative. So the equilibrium expression for Ka is equal to this one. That is a product of this product side concentration divided by the reactant, that is the acid. Because water is in large quantity, we need not introduce that into this term. Or we can simply write H positive only instead of hydronium ion, A minus by H. So strength of acid is a measure of quantity, measured quantitatively from magnitude of Ka. Just looking the example, the Ka value is directly proportional to H positive ion concentration. So acids are proton donors, and that means the higher the concentration of H positive, greater the strength of the acid. So strength of acid is measured quantitatively from the magnitude of Ka. And greater the V value of Ka, stronger is the acid, hence the greater concentration of H positive ion. We should also understand that only weak acids have Ka value associated with them. Why? Only weak acids are having an equilibrium like this. Or strong acid like HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, there is no reversible type of reaction. They will be simply reacting and will not be reacting back. So there will be no equilibrium constant also. K for HF is 7.1 times 10 raised to negative 4, and for HCN it is 4.9 times 10 to the power of minus 10. Just looking this, we can see that HCN is having a very low value of the order of 10 to the power minus 10. So that just dividing one by other, we can see that the HF is about 1.5 million times stronger than HCN. Just for information, some of the values are given for nitrous acid. The value is 4.5 times 10 raised to negative 4. For formic acid, it is 1.7 times 10 raised to minus 4. For benzoic acid, it is 6.5 times 10 raised to minus 5. For acetic acid, it is 1.8 times 10 raised to minus 5. By looking this, we can know that HNO2, HCOH, that is formic acid and nitrous acid, are stronger than the corresponding other two acids. So the next question is, what is a conjugate acid and a conjugate base? As I have already explained, a conjugate acid is formed from this equation as H3O positive. The base become a conjugate acid. Here water is acting as a base. Water can act as also as an acid also in some certain cases, especially by reacting with the ammonia. It can act. So it is called amphoteric in nature, water. Here acid is HA, base is H2O. What happened here? The base H2O is converted into hydronium ion and acid HA is converted into A minus. Here hydronium ion or H3O positive is called the conjugate acid and A minus is called the conjugate base. So, you know, we are coming to the how to answer the question, and therefore base ionization constant is we are interested. Base ionization constant represented as Kb, and we know ammonia is a base, and ammonia while reacting with the water, here water is acting as a acid. In presence of the base ammonia, water is acting as an acid and it is converted to NH4 positive. The base ammonia is converted to now a conjugate acid, and H2O is converted to a conjugate base OH minus. For that equilibrium constant, it will be equal to the product concentrations divided by the reactant concentration. H2O is a large excess, so that it is equal to a constant times H2O concentration is equal to nothing but the Kb, and Kb is equal to the ammonium ion concentration times OH minus ion concentration divided by NH3. It is found to be equal to 1.7 times 10 raised to minus 5. So Kb value for this ammonia is this much value. Next, first, from the very beginning, I have asked you, such students who know the relationship between K and Kb can easily solve within seconds. So we will just derive for the common general students. What is the relationship between, or just remembering, recording what they have already studied, what is the relationship between K and Kb? We can derive using the example. See, here it is acetic acid or methanoic acid, so ionized as CH3CO minus plus H positive ion. Therefore, Ka, acid ionization constant, will be equal to this. That is the product side concentrations divided by the reactant concentration. So, conjugate base CH3OH will react with the water. On reacting with the water, here what happens is CH3COOH is formed. And therefore, it is a conjugate base in the former case. Conjugate base in the former case is now acting with the acid. Water here is acting as an acid, and therefore it is formed a product CH3COH minus this is a conjugate acid actually, and acid itself, and this will be a base, conjugate base. For this base ionization constant will be equal to this concentration, the conjugate ionization concentration divided multiplied by conjugate base concentration whole divided by the conjugate base concentration, this one. And here also water is in large excess, so that we neglected it. Or equilibrium constant times water concentration will be this one, that is equal to Kp. So the product of this ionization constant on careful examination, just substitute the value of Ka. Ka is equal to this one, and Kb is equal to this part. And on writing it, you can see that it's equal to CH3COO minus times H positive divided by CH3COH. That is this one. And Kb value you are substituting, we get to CH3COH times OH minus divided by CH3COO minus. This is the second one that we obtained. And closer observation of this, we can see that there is common 2 CH3COO minus, and again common CH3COH on closing. Finally, left thing is H positive ion concentration times OH minus ion concentration. And this product of the proton concentration and OH minus concentration is known as Kw, ionic product of water. The standard value of ionic product of water and standard conditions is 1 times 10 raised to minus 14. So from this equation, Ka, Kb is equal to Kw. Therefore, Kb will be equal to Kw divided by K. Kb is equal to Kw divided by Ka. On substituting the values, Ka is given actually as 1 times 10 raised to minus 12. And Kw value we know, 1 times 10 raised to minus 14. So what is this value equal to? Give me the value. This value is equal to 1.0 times 10 raised to minus 12. Is it so? So this is the value, and therefore from the question, the answer is D. In the coming classes, we'll do the next problems, multiple choice questions in these topics and the other 10 topics of IB chemistry, that is International Baccalaureate Chemistry, for the standard level and higher level. Thank you.